So let's begin with the very first cycle, cycle one. In this cycle, there is nothing to dispatch and nothing to write, of course. So the only thing that we really need to be concerned is with issuing an instruction. The load will look at the reservation stations and look at basically the load store queue in this case and see that there is an empty space there so we can issue. So we will mark that this instruction gets done in cycle one as far as issue is concerned. Now we have a busy load store queue entry. The operation is a load. Now the load uses an address. It doesn't really use a value. So in this case, we will use our R2, which is 100, and add 34 to it. And that address will be computed before we put it in the load store queue. So let's say that this value is noted here as 134. So this is really the address. We are not waiting for anything, but this load will produce a floating point value and put it in F6. So we need to rename F6 to point to load 1. And the load doesn't dispatch in the same cycle because we said that we cannot do that. So this kind of concludes the issuing of this load. Now let's look at the second cycle. In the second cycle, we will try to issue this load, and there is a free unit, so we will do that. It's 45 from R3, so it's going to be 245. Again, this is done by the address unit. It's not done by the ALUs or anything, so this addition gets done immediately. And we are not waiting for anything because the load doesn't really need to wait for any floating point registers. And then F2 is where we're going to put our result. So we're going to mark this as LD2. And this is it as far as the issuing is concerned in this cycle. We will dispatch this load now. So its execution begins in cycle 2 because everything is ready for it. And now we need to consider, okay, so it takes 2 cycles to do a load. Does the write back happen at the end of the second cycle or does it happen in the cycle after that? In this case, we will assume that the write back happens after the execution is done. So the execution of the load will be done in cycles 2 and 3 and the write back will happen in cycle 4. So we will kind of note that basically we will be able to write in cycle 4 here just to kind of remember that.